To what extent does the e-skills campaign can become part of a digital literacy campaign for the entire European population, no matter of age?
Well, I think when one is considering e-skills, it's worth thinking of it in two parts. One is the skills that we need for people to be able to work in our industry. But then there's a wider set of skills that everybody who's economically active, who has a job, needs in order to be able to use the tools and services that are available for that for today. And I think that in both of those parts, both people who could work in our industry or in the people who are going to use our products and services to be more productive and economically successful, age doesn't matter. So I think it very much can be part of an overall digital literacy campaign that can be effective regardless of age.
Do you plan to extend the campaign
so
to other ages?
So this is a specific campaign that's been funded partly by the European Commission, and we're very grateful that they have seen that it's appropriate to put some resources to get this campaign going. The campaign itself, as in throughout Europe, has had many different facets and hasn't only been concentrated on one particular age group. So already it has hit many different age groups.
The campaign is targeted specifically to young people. What are the specific ways in which young people are guided to the ITNC-based studies and career?
So whilst young people has been a major focus, it's not really been in practice exclusively at young people. And ICT is really important for people of all ages, but particularly young people, because for two reasons. One is they might well be attracted to a job in our industry and they clearly need to have some knowledge as well as sort of advanced numeracy and analytical skills. But even if they're not going to be working in the ICT industry, they're undoubtedly going to be working in industry that uses ICT, and so they will need those sorts of digital literacy skills.
Internet is mostly used in information and entertainment purposes. How does Digital Europe familiarize the public with the real useful value of ITNC?
Digital Europe is mostly about promoting the views of the digital industry towards policymakers and regulators. So we see our job as making sure that people who are making policy decisions or regulatory decisions understand the impact of those decisions on our industry in order that they can make better decisions so that our industry will thrive and our industry can play its full part in delivering the social and economic benefit that we all need in Europe.
Currently, Europe does not cover all requirements in the IT workforce. Is the e-skills program part of the solution?
Oh, very much so. We know that there are, whichever figures you look at, there are skills shortages and likely to be even worse skills shortages, and therefore people with ICT skills are going to have a much better chance of finding a rewarding job in Europe in the next few years.
Are there any solutions, any other solutions besides these skills?
Well, there are lots of other things that need to be done, lots of structural reforms, but really our industry is looking at it from the point of view of what role can our industry play in the economic and social revival in Europe.
It's the end of the second e-skills program. Can you give us some general statistics from the information you've gathered so far?
Well, we don't know how many people will have been reached by this campaign yet, but it will run into the millions. I mean, just to give you a flavour of the number of different countries involved in the closing in the closing ceremony, there were people from 35 different parts of Europe, different countries and regions of the Union and beyond, obviously, and we reckon that there have been over 250 events of one sort or another, as I say, reaching many millions of people.
Do you have some data about the impact of the campaign over the youth?
Too early to say yet, too early to say.